It seems that recently, AI is getting more attention than ever. Who would have thought that in 2023, you can have AI write a full paper for you? There's no need to sweat over essays anymore. Just have Sunny do it.
No.
But I have to say, with the advancements made in artificial intelligence, I have my concerns. For example, are jobs going to be taken away from the hardworking man and given to a robot? Is art and entertainment going to become AI generated instead of human generated? And is SpongeBob going to keep saying the N-word? What the fuck going on? Yes, I know it's AI, but why did it sound like that wasn't SpongeBob's first time saying it though? Nah, like for real, I feel like he said that shit before. SpongeBob, what do you want? You're like a brother to me, but I gotta see what's good with this. Should you be out here speaking like this? Like, why are you singing NBA Youngboy? It just sounds too natural for my liking. Have you been practicing that, big bro? When I first heard him talking like this, I almost cried damn near. I just thought I knew my bro better than that, that's all. Top of the morning, top of the morning, top of the morning, top of the morning, top of the morning. Hold on, let's get this shit, let's get this shit, let's get this shit, let's Like, what these niggas on like? Okay, now you're just taking the piss, SpongeBob. What do you mean, what these niggas on? What are you trying to say? If you told me a dude like this was saying it, then I wouldn't be surprised, but this right here doesn't make sense to me. But through all the pain and sleepless nights this caused me, I had to think, has SpongeBob ever said this shit in his show? Alright, so this episode starts with SpongeBob trying to leave work before being told he has to take out the trash. When he goes out there, he sees some graffiti and starts reading it. Now look at this.
Stop! What's this one? Crabs is a... Crabs is a...
Okay, stop it right here. What could have been said here? We all may have our opinions, but after hearing SpongeBob rap NBA Youngboy, I think I have a clue. Let's run it back.
Crabs is a... Crabs is a
nigga.
And that's me being generous. I don't know this guy anymore. He could have said it with the ER, but some of you may say, nah, he didn't say that. Stop being ridiculous. Okay, cool, let's keep going.
Do you kiss your mother with that mouth?
Well, sometimes, but not recently.
Hi, Garbage Man. Hi, SpongeBob.
Hi, Patrick. Nah, not that word. That word.
Oh, hey, I think I know what that means. That's one of those sentence enhancers.
Sentence enhancers?
You use them when you want to talk fancy. You just sprinkle it over anything you say and whammo!
Did you hear that? Did you hear that? Sentence enhancer. What curse word enhances a sentence more than the N-word? Think of rap and hip-hop, one of the most popular genres. Can you even find a rap song without the N-word?
You know about my pain. If I quote it, nigga, I wrote it, nigga. Six headshots, Ali wrote a nigga. Pop another clip and I'm reloaded, nigga. Ain't no way around it, I'm the coldest, nigga. Do a nigga dirty like to clone, my nigga. Get you cleaned up, then I fold you, nigga. Shout out to the haters who promote a nigga. Flow hot, whip cold, I'm bipolar, nigga.
Ask yourself how many of those were necessary. Exactly, none. It could have been said in another way, but guess what? The sentence just came in. It's enhanced. Don't ask me what that means. But look at Patrick's mouth when he says it. It may be censored, but we can lip read. Let's slow it down.
Nigga.
Alright then, Patrick, the fuck? As the episode goes on, SpongeBob and Patrick keep swearing, and eventually Mr. Krabs has to handle it.
But Mr. Krabs, we were only using our sentence enhancers.
There ain't nothing fancy about that word! Okay, boys. I want you to promise me you'll never use that word again.
We promise.
Lesson learned, right? They head over to SpongeBob's house and they play a nice game of snakes and ladders. Patrick does well while SpongeBob doesn't. This leads to SpongeBob getting pressed and swearing again.
You said number 11.
I didn't mean, you gotta understand, Patrick. I was trying, what I meant to say, something's just slipped out. You gotta understand.
Wow, some things just slip out, SpongeBob, huh? Interesting. Does that remind you of anything?
Even though you're devil, 'cause it's beauty in the struggle, nigga. It's beauty in the struggle, nigga.
Ah! Ah!
I never use that word. I swear to fucking God, this isn't content. I never use that fucking word. I've listened to rap songs every day on this subathon, and I always change it out for brother.
Fouseytube SquarePants? After SpongeBob curses, Patrick tries to snitch on him before slipping up himself. They race over to Mr. Krabs and expose each other.
Do my ears deceive me? You two should be ashamed. You two need to be taught a lesson. Now the both of yous wait right here. I'll be back.
What's gonna happen to us?
Pause it here. Think for a second what the punishment could be. I don't know, maybe like put a dollar in a jar every time you swear? Something light, like that's the question Patrick presented. What is gonna happen to them? What's their punishment? Listen to this dude's answer.
We'll probably get 40 lashes.
Nigga, what?
Is this nigga serious?
Certified side nigga secret.
What did you say? What
the fuck? Stop it! What the fuck is that?
Really, SpongeBob, really, bro. I don't know about you, when I hear the word lashes, I think of slavery. You know, whipping somebody. SpongeBob, you damn near do deserve a beating for that shit. What the heck?
Stephen A. Smith, I sentence you to 4,000 lashes for conduct unbecoming a black man.
But the conspiracy is not done here. This brings us to another episode where we have to question Mr. SquarePants yet again. This episode is titled Squirrel Jokes. It starts off with SpongeBob trying to be a stand-up comedian. His jokes aren't good and he gets violated by the audience.
Hey, funny guy! I got a joke for you! What smells rotten and puts people to sleep?
Noxious gas?
No! Your act!
Now, after everyone is laughing at him, not with him, SpongeBob quickly looks into the audience to find something he can make fun of. He looks directly at Sandy Cheeks. Now, notice how Sandy looks compared to everyone else here. She's the only brown character here, the only non-fish, the one that's different, the one that isn't from there originally. And this is who SpongeBob picks.
Did you ever notice how big squirrels' teeth are?
That's true. Huh?
I mean, hey, you could land a plane on those things. And what's up with that squirrel fur? I guess fleas need a home too, huh?
Squirrel fur!
And they smell! But hey, you'd stink too if you spent 3 months buried in dirt. Hey, why does it take more than one squirrel to change a light bulb?
Why?
Because they're so darn stupid.
That's a good one, eh, Sandy?
Complete violation of his quote-unquote friend. Making fun of Sandy's squirrelness was the easiest thing he could have done. It's like making a black joke. SpongeBob, don't let me catch you outside. It's up for you now. You're doing too much. After his set is finished, Sandy comes over to address the silliness.
SpongeBob.
Did you like the show?
Well, actually, SpongeBob, no. Those jokes are hurtful, and you know it.
We all gotta laugh at ourselves once in a while. I do it all the time.
You're right, SpongeBob. I was being a little too sensitive. No hard feelings.
Sounds all sweet and calm, right? That's until SpongeBob's jokes start having real-life consequences for Sandy.
Guys, it's the stupid squirrel.
I know, let's try and communicate with it.
They start treating Sandy different just because she is a squirrel. And this is coming directly from SpongeBob's rhetoric. Keep in mind, they don't have a Martin Luther King Jr. in the Bikini Bottom. At night, it's time for some comedy again. SpongeBob is backstage and he literally doesn't have any other joke planned besides saying squirrels are dumb.
SpongeBob, this is serious. Since you've been telling them jokes, people have been treating me different. I'm just asking you as a friend, please lay off them squirrel jokes, okay? Tell some of them other jokes you got.
Other jokes? I got a million of them.
Thanks, SpongeBob. I knew you'd understand.
Beautiful act of kindness and friendship. SpongeBob sees that Sandy is dismayed over these foolish little jokes, and he decides to put an end to it. Like he said, he has a million other jokes. He gets on stage ready to be a good friend, ready to show what stand-up comedy is about, ready to make people laugh.
Hi. did you hear about the goldfish who went bankrupt? Now he's a bronze fish.
What?
What did he say?
I guess you heard that one.
I haven't heard it! Good one, SpongeBob!
Thank you, you're too kind. Hey, what about this water? I mean, this stuff's everywhere.
Tell the one about the squirrel and the light bulb!
Squirrel jokes! Squirrel jokes! Squirrel jokes! Squirrel jokes! Squirrel jokes! Squirrel jokes!
What do I do? What do I do? SpongeBob, you've got a choice to make. Your friends or your career.
Bro, what the fuck, SpongeBob? No way you pop out doing the equivalent of blackface. What are you doing? What type of behavior is this? Who told you this is okay? And Patrick, don't think we didn't see you advocating for these jokes. Nigga, who are you on a date with? Get up and read a book, dumbass. Triangle head, bitch, I hate. Nah, but like for real, the whole Bikini Bottom gotta get burned down for this. I'm not having it anymore. Look at the way this dude is side-eyeing Sandy. This is nasty. On the outside, he looks like a fun, innocent, peaceful little sponge man. But on the inside, he knows he's unstoppable. He knows he can say the N-word and get away with it. He can't die, he can't lose. He can make fun of blacks all he wants. So the question switches from has SpongeBob said the N-word to can SpongeBob say the N-word? And I say, yes, he can. Bruh, let me stop smearing my bro's name like this. SpongeBob, you're a real one. We've been locked in since day one. I don't care that when you sing Roddy Ricch, you say the N-word proud as hell. Because you're my bro. You're not racist. Sometimes you just let things slip out. Just like fouseytube. Sometimes you don't think too hard about your actions. But in the end, you always right your wrongs. And for that, I think you deserve something incredible. The right to say the N-word as loud as you can. Go ahead, SpongeBob. You don't have to hide it anymore.
Really?
Yes, really. Go ahead, bro.
Really, really?
Yes, bro, go ahead, stop playing.
Really, really, really?
Say it, SpongeBob!
Steve, if you think me, you finna see what's up. Hey, you wanna fuck with me,